Wednesday morning, May the 9th. Bob Atkins with us here on the Treasure Coast Southern. Glenn Stevens coming in. Show you the clock. It's 25 past. We've been spouting hot air all morning so far. Larry Dreyer, Rick here. We will be cranking things up, a little workshop on the railroad, and check on our projects, see how everything has gone. The Sunset Limited, Southern Pacific, has stopped right across the G-Door River. We will find out why after a moment. A couple of new things. New toy here, an Atlas engine. We're going to open that up in a moment, take a look at it. We, of course, will open the laptop, show you where things are on the railroad. 920 has gone north this morning. 210 is way above us up at the auto ramp.
Okay, now the G30, I don't know about, but I would imagine it's...
Take a good look at the workshop table. We can see 50% of the surface, which is more than we've ever seen before. Bob taking a look at a new decoder unit. Includes sound speaker. We will be installing one of those today. And we're going to be talking about one of my favorites, the Alco RS3. Beautiful little units. We'll be back. Okay, I got something to show you inside the box. An engine that I remember running all the way back in 1960. You can see the Dash and Dan emblem on her flank. Dash and Dan was born in 1958, the year that my grandfather retired from the Long Island.
I have one laying around here.
We're going to take a look here at this unit, find out whether we can get a decoder inside it, find out where the sound will fit, and once we get that, all that established, we're going to go for a ride. Okay, at this point, I have removed the long hood from the frame and the motor. Give you a look at that. And we are going to take a look at the green thing, that circuit board, mounted on top of the motor. We would like to replace that board with this board. If we can do that, we will be ready to run on the decoder CC, DCC equipped railway. The board that's on top of this unit now controls the headlights. And if we replace it with this board, it will not only control the headlights, but it will communicate with the DCC system and allow this engine to run on this railroad. All right, next step, please. What I really would like to do is to step up one more level and get one with sound. In order to do that, we will have to hollow out either this radiator housing or the cab housing. I'm going to roll that over and show you inside here. If we hollowed this out large enough to fit a device like so, we would be able to get the speaker. The speaker is the largest, most difficult part to install of the entire job. So let us work on that. We'll be back.
Because that's a used decoder, so it may already have a number.
Okay, we have, the shell is still off the unit. The unit is on the test track. We have swapped out the decoder board that was on here, the light board that was on it, for a decoder board. And we are going to see if we get anything. What programming number did you use?
I'm not. I'm reading what might have been in the old decoder.
Okay.
This says 600.
out. We are going to put it up here and program in 600.
Off of the test track, the programming track, put it on the main line, the handheld read 600. This is a used decoder. We're going to see if the number 600 will respond. We got a conflict here, folks.
Okay, just picking up. I put it on the wall front.
However, it didn't respond. Now,
we have 600 dialed in on the handheld.
Getting nothing.
And we have no response at all from 1555.
Okay.
Let's try something else.
So you got pointed ends on this, and the truck's got square ends. It takes an axle kit, but I mean an axle set with a flat end on it, so they're pointed. They got the wheels in there, but they don't roll very well.
Okay, you need a special tool to...
Yeah, but that ain't gonna help because these trucks are made for a flat end wheel set.
You get, you get the flat or the pointed, one or the other.
Yeah, well, he's got the flat.
We haven't had that clash yet here, have we?
That's why the wheels, that's why the axles were so bowed. They had pointy ends and a flat end on it. So now I need this.
We've got decoders all over the board. We're going to swap in the original decoder, make sure everything works, and then we will swap back to replacement decoders, including light bars. Let's try that right.
Here's another one.